Hello, everybody. What's going on? My name is Vash TSB, and welcome to something new that I'm doing for Bonfire Lit. This is a type of video that I've been wanting to do for quite a while now, I think. This is just going to be sort of a question and answer format type video where you, the viewer, can send me a question, and I'll treat it either as a simple answer or as an entire topic, which I will cover over the course of a long ramble, as is the case with this video. So what is this format called? This is called Ask Vash, because I'm going to be taking a lot of these questions from my ask.fm/VashTSB. If you would like to submit a question, I don't know how often I'll be doing these. This is just sort of a bit of a test run to see how it'll go, so yeah. So realistically, I'm going to do my best to take ask.fm questions that I don't really think I could answer in the allotted text amount, or just something I don't really feel like typing a bunch of shit out for. This is going to be completely unscripted and without an outline, so hopefully you guys are okay with that. Sent in by Anonymous, any idea why some content creators, for any form of entertainment, start off okay, then get better over time, while others start good and grow worse over time? So, this is actually a really good question, but obviously I'm going to do my best to relate this to YouTube, because that is what I have the most experience with. That's technically not true. I definitely do have way more years experience doing stage performances for things like choir and all that, but, you know, people know me for the YouTube, so let's talk about the YouTube stuff. So, as to the first part of your question, let me just pull that up really quick. As to the first part of your question, any idea why some content creators start off okay, then get better over time? So, to answer this question effectively, I think it would be good to sort of talk about where content comes from. And in my experience, there tends to be something that I like to refer to as the content creation trifecta, or more of a triangle, different core concepts or ideas that need to be in some sort of equilibrium for a good piece of content to be made. Now, what are these three pillars? They are inspiration, knowledge, and effort. Now, inspiration, knowledge, and effort, those are the three core pillars, I guess you could say, of content creation on the whole. What I mean by this is that you need to create anything, really, be it content for YouTube, a song for a band, or whatever, you need a certain degree of inspiration. And when I say inspiration, I don't want you to think like, you know, a cure for cancer or something like that, because that's not what that really means. When I'm speaking about inspiration or creativity, this is something that applies somewhat universally across all three levels of content creation. For the three levels, for those of you who don't know, are pre-production, production, and post-production. I'll get into each of those as we cover this. So inspiration for pre-production literally is just the idea of a piece of content, like you wanting to make something. The second pillar is knowledge. Knowledge, as it pertains to content creation, is usually technical knowledge. And I'll go outside of YouTube content creation to help prove this point. If you are inspired to write a song, you need to know some form of music theory, or you need to know how to play an instrument or how to sing something in a specific way. You need to have the prior knowledge to know how to make the ideas in your head come to life, basically. And this applies, once again, across all three levels of the creative process. And you'll notice, too, that as you get more knowledge, you start to become more creative because your eyes open to what is possible. And as you become more creative, it pushes you to learn how to do new things so you can actually once again learn more about the tools that you use to be creative. And finally, the final thing was effort, is the time and effort that you put into making something look or sound as good or polished as possible. If you have the idea for an effect and you have the knowledge of how to do that effect, how much effort are you going to put into that effect to make it look as good as possible? And you can really start to see how these three core concepts interact with each other when you're making a piece of content. You could spend weeks, if not months, if not years in writing, where you're just constantly going through ideas for how you're going to write or structure something. And then once you finally have it all together and you finally all have it in post, you want to have all of these different visual effects or different transitions and things like that. And once again, you need to know how that's done within the tools that you have. And with all of that, you need to have the time and the drive to put that much effort into the content that you're producing. And I think that once you sort of wrap your head around this idea of, once again, effort, creativity, and knowledge, that you start to understand why some content creators do get better over time from an okay start. So yes, I did eventually tie this back in, just like I said I would. So as far as that stuff goes, really what it matters about is, and it'll change over time, but what you'll notice is when you're first starting out, creativity for a YouTuber, if this is your first YouTube channel, or if you've never really taken it seriously before, and you just suddenly start deciding that you want to start making serious, or not really serious, but serious in terms of you want it to be something that you work on and make. You start to shift over to that type of content, suddenly there's a big jump in what's required of you. And not everybody's capable of making that jump. But regardless, creativity is usually very scattered. Like when you're starting out and you're just okay, as you said in your Ask.fm question, creativity and inspiration is all over the fucking place. You have no idea what you want to make, really. You just want to get in there and see what works for you and then focus on that from there. So it's very experimental, it's very trial and error. But within that also, if it's your first time working with editing software like Adobe Premiere or Adobe After Effects or Sony Vegas Pro or anything like that, then your knowledge will be quite low. And because of that, you will notice a certain degree of diminishing returns with how much effort you put into that content. And what I mean when I say that is, how do I say this without being a dick? Let's just say it's something simple. You want to just have a simple zoom in on like a piece of video or a text or a logo or whatever for like comedic effect. And you don't really know how you would go about doing that. Like, obviously, if anybody spent any time in Adobe Premiere or After Effects or whatever, they know how scale keyframing works. But if you're just getting into it for the first time, you probably don't know. And because of that, you're going to have to learn how you do scaling up and scaling down and things of that nature. So while you're learning that, that's where most of your effort is going to be. So by the time you're actually done learning how to do the effect, you may have spent a lot of time doing that and just grasping the concept. So you might not really want to put enough effort into it to also make it look good. So realistically, the more, I guess another way to put this is, the more knowledge you have going into it, the more focused your effort can be. That's really what I want to get across here. So, and of course, as you go on in this sort of content creation cycle and scheme, you start to develop more knowledge and you start to develop the ability to be more efficient and focused with your effort. So that instead of just figuring out how the hell you're going to do this effect, you're like, okay, I know how to do that effect, but now I'm going to spend the time that I would have spent learning how to do that and instead refocus that on polishing it and making it look good. So yeah, that's really how it goes. And you'll notice too, as far as YouTubers go, like say a YouTuber gets a big break, you know, for something, or any content producer of any type gets a big break and suddenly they find themselves in a position where they get to do that professionally. What then happens is that frees up a lot of their spare time, or a lot of their time rather, that they're not spending on work or at school, so they can instead spend more of that time on effort for making that content look better. So really, that's why you notice how people improve over time. Take a channel like Chase Face Show. Chase Face, at least when I was introduced to him, the guy was basically completely professional by the time I first met him. And when I say met him, I mean like found his channel. When I first found Chase Face Show through my friend Mark, it was instantaneous. Like he started off with a shit ton of knowledge of how to give good line deliveries due to his experience as a voice actor, how to do good editing, because apparently he's worked in After Effects and things like that in the past, and, you know, just knowledge of how to structure a script, because evidently he's worked in writing or as a script writer before and things like that. So he has that prerequisite knowledge, so when he has the idea for something, he can spend months and months, like he did with his Sonic video, to make that content look as good as possible and flow as good as possible. Totally A stuff. So that's really where you start to see content producers improving. And really, if they stick with it and they want to keep pushing forward, is where you'll start to see this improvement over time. So content creators start off okay, then get better over time, whilst others start good and grow worse over time. Okay. So, going back to the pillars, there are several things which can influence the development in either three of those fields. One of which is exciting new territory. If you're going into something and you're learning a bunch of new stuff, and it's stuff that you want to learn, then your knowledge about how to produce good content will expand substantially, and it will do so over a very short amount of time, or at least in reference to iterations, it'll do so very quickly. But once you sort of hit that peak, and this is really where the viewership gets to interact with the content creator in a negative way. So the phenomenon that I'm referring to right now is burnout. So burnout pretty much occurs when you're covering just one thing for way too long and you start to get tired of just doing the same old thing. And I think that this can even happen if you're covering a variety series. Realistically, the more that you do this sort of content production thing, the more likely that you're going to need to be able to just sort of take a step back and recharge your batteries and just sort of recapture that focus of creative energy, really, is what it comes down to. Because when you're creatively engaged in something, you're generally having a good time, or you're at least enjoying yourself on some level, or it's beneficial to you in some way. But if you're constantly feeling like you need to produce content quickly, and you need to just keep focusing on one thing, and especially in a professional context, YouTubers really do need to focus on just one type of thing, because I'll pull the relevant example. Hyperbit Hero is sort of going through this right now, where he has two videos, both of which are fantastic, but there's such a massive disparity in who took interest in that content that it's really kind of upsetting. There was a review for an anime Kaiji or Ryoji Kaji Ultimate Survivor. I don't think I'm getting the name right, but it is Ultimate Survivor. That anime review, which he did not too long ago, was fucking awesome. I wanted to watch the anime afterwards, and I'm planning on doing so this weekend when I get off work. I'm just going to sit down and watch an anime. It's going to be fantastic. He does that, and, you know, clearly a core subset of his audience who was going to watch it anyway watched it. But when you compare that to something like, say, his Devil May Cry and DMC Devil May Cry videos about Virgil, there's just a huge disparity of tens of thousands of people who just did not give enough of a fuck about the subject matter to watch the video. And I'll vouch for it personally, though, you know, there's nothing qualitatively speaking wrong with the Ultimate Survivor video. It's a fantastic video, very entertaining, and it informs you about something that you might not have known about otherwise, and it does so without spoilers. But nobody, comparatively, contextually, nobody really took interest in it. And then you compare that with, say, the success of his new Halo video, and you really start to see how fans will play favorites with certain types of content in terms of subject of discussion. Where the Halo video is fantastic. I think it's great. Very well produced. Very well meaning. Very informative. I'm not much of a Halo guy, but I watched it anyway. It was great. And a lot of people watched it too. But imagine for a second that really you weren't sort of a more variety-centric channel like Hayden's or like, I guess, mine now, or whoever's. And you tried to branch out like that. And going back to the Vaadi Vidya example, I'm not going to say anything in specific, but let's just say I imagine that he's in a position to where he would like to cover more content than he's currently able to, but because this is his job, producing content for YouTube is his current profession, he's in a position to where he can't really afford to use that creativity, that knowledge, or that effort on something which will not give him decent return of investment of same. And that's really where the idea of YouTube or of viewership can start to negatively impact the quality of content that you start to see out of a producer. And really, this just applies on all levels, you know? And some producers can just get burnt out. It really, it just does, it gets that simple, where you have, or like, you have the creative spark for something, but you're so disinterested in the topic that you don't even want to put in as much effort as possible to just sort of make those ideas as good as they can be. Or you don't really feel like researching to make something sound good. You know, knowledge is more than just the technical knowledge. It also applies to the literal knowledge of the subject you're covering. And, you know, it just shows. It does. And I don't really think there's anything wrong or damning. Like, as soon as someone says they're going to go full-time with YouTube, it's like, oh, fuck, it's ruined. It's ruined. It's over. That's not what I'm saying. But what I am saying is you need a break. You need time to sort of recharge and just sort of refine that creative spark. And you also need to be able to be confident enough in yourself to branch out like that and hope that the audience goes with you. Because really, content of all types in any context is really just people wanting to move forward in some way or another. Whether that's I want more viewers, I want more reach, I want more people to see this content, or if it's like I want to become more creatively expressive, I want to get more information across in a shorter amount of time. Whatever it is, pretty much all content creators want to move forward. They want to make progress. And there are various ways of doing that. You'll find that along that way, some people do. They just lose certain aspects about themselves that make them good. You can't just throw yourself at Adobe Premiere for 5 straight days making an hour-long piece of content with very little creative spark in how you're going to deliver the information throughout the span of that hour and still expect to be proud of what you've made. Yeah, that's really all I have to say about this topic. I know we ran a little bit long and I had to cover a lot, but hopefully that's a sufficient answer. Really, just people get better. TLDR, people get better and people get tired. That's really what it comes down to. Once again, whether it's music, people can run out of musical ideas. It happens to the best of us. Nobody is an infinite well of creativity, you know? We all have those points where, and money does come in and play a part as well. It just depends. But once again, just, and this is where we're going to go a little bit off the beaten path with this one. If you do have a content creator who is starting to falter, you know, maybe they're suffering a deficiency in one of these areas, you know, where it's like they're either getting really tired of covering the same old thing, or they're trying to do new things, but they don't know how, they don't know where to go to know how, or other things in their life are cropping up and their free time is just getting dominated, so they don't really have the ability to make it look good. You know, maybe that's a degree of understanding that maybe we could just have. I don't know. Content producers are still people. I know this went into a weird preachy direction, but I don't know. Once again, unscripted. I hope you guys enjoyed the first edition of Ask Vash. If you would like to contribute a piece of content or a question, feel free to do so either in the comment section of this video, on my Twitter, at VashTSB, or at ask.fm/VashTSB. You can post on my wall, you can do so anonymously, and I'll either reply to it with text, or I'll do one of these if I don't really feel like replying to it in text, and I just feel like running my mouth for however long this was. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. My name has been VashTSB, and I'll see you guys soon.